Yekare de moshoko brota, lehere brota. Mara moshoko brota, lehere brota. Yekare moshekere de brota. Malehere moya karahara. Beloved, I bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. For those that were watching the live video, by the grace of God, I said, in the month of February, the Lord laid on my heart that we undergo a teaching called Our Friend, the Holy Spirit. Our Friend, the Holy Spirit. You see, David said a prayer. He says, cast me not away from your presence, Lord, and do not take your Holy Spirit away from me. David was saying that, God, you know, you can take anything from me, but not your Holy Spirit. Beloved, I want you to understand that you can lose the Holy Spirit. There are a lot of people that perhaps have lost the Holy Spirit unaware. And so in the month of February, by the grace of God, we'll be going through a series called Our Friend, the Holy Spirit. It is going to help us, by the grace of God, to draw closer, to equip ourselves, and to, you know, understand some of the ways of our friend, the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so today or tonight, we dealt with grieve not the Holy Spirit. Ephesians 4 verse 30 says, grieve not the Holy Spirit. What does it mean to grieve the Holy Spirit? The word to grieve means to cause pain, to stress out, to cause sadness. The Holy Spirit, you must first understand, is a person. When Jesus was leaving, he said, I'm leaving, but a new person is coming, which is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not just a gift. It's not just a manifestation. The gifts are what the person gives. So speaking in tongues, manifesting, operating in different dimensions, you know, are just a manifestation. They're just things that the friend or our friend, the Holy Spirit, gives. Amen. As Ephesians 4 verse 30 said, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Do not cause the friend or the person of the Holy Spirit pain. Don't stress him. What are some of the ways that your friend can do to you that can stress you out? When they nag, you're always asking, persistently asking, they ask one thing. Give me. One thing, the same thing. They nag. When they think evil of you, when they blame you. And some of the times, that's what we do to the Holy Spirit. Anything negative happens, and we begin to question the existence of God. We begin to blame God. You don't love me. But we don't know what our friend is doing in the background. He's a friend that is praying for you. Romans 8:26 says he's making intercession for you and I. Beloved, I want you to join me and the rest of the believers that are Jesus-centered as we go through the series, Our Friend, the Holy Spirit. You see, when you grieve the Holy Spirit, you can lose him. To grieve means to cause pain